Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to the pool room. We are here tonight again, once again. My name is Eugene Wakefield.
Hi, I'm Candace. Welcome to the Cocoon Room.
Where we talk about Black issues. We also have a special guest who was here the last time, and we'd like to thank him for coming again, Mr. Dr. Howard. How are you, sir?
I'm pretty good, Dr. Ben Howard. Full disclosure.
Tell him the whole name, Ben Howard, Dr. Ben Howard.
And so he is family because that is also Candace's cousin. So we are so grateful for him being here tonight again. Blessing us with his presence, with his knowledge and insight. And tonight is also part two of our healthy discussion. And this one is particularly, this podcast is particularly around, around healthy dieting. And so before we get started, do you, Dr. Howard or Candace, have any opening remarks?
I do not.
You know, I kind of do. I would be, you know, I have to kind of say something that about the scripture, you know, and the word says that my people suffer because of lack of knowledge. And I think our current situation is just about knowledge. There's a lot of knowledge out here, and you have to decipher what knowledge is best for you. And my people, we need to start listening to the call. So I'm here tonight to talk about how we need to listen to the call, how we can move forward as a people, and what's best for us.
Absolutely. I'm with that.
I agree.
Before we get started, I would like, because as protocol, as we always do, like to start with scripture of the day. And Candace, I'll let you take it from there.
All right. So I chose the scripture, Genesis 1 and 11. And God said, let the earth sprout vegetation, plants yielding seed and fruit, trees bearing fruit, in which is their seed, each according to its kind, one on earth, and it was so. So I chose that scripture because we are talking about healthy eating today and what that looks like. I know healthy eating, it is a lifestyle change. And so last time we had Dr. Ben Howard on the show, he talked about fruit, getting fruits and vegetables and seeds. And as you guys know, if you're going to eat fruits and vegetables, you have to eat the ones who have the seeds that are in them. If not, it is genetically modified. So that's why I chose that scripture.
And then in unnecessary order, we're going to do the word of the day. The word is seed, Swahili translation, Miss Silence, so it's bagu. And it's a flowering plant's unit of reproduction capable of developing into another such plant. And so I think that's fitting. Was a great word for us today, especially when it goes alongside with our podcast being that we're evolving. And so a seed is also evolving and developing into something. And so I think that is wonderfully put for today's podcast. Well, for the podcast, obviously, but for today's broadcast. And so with that, we would like to, I don't know how to transition because I don't know if you want to get into healthy dieting right now and just the topics you want to cover, Dr. Howard.
Are you asking me that or are you asking Candace that?
Yes.
He's asking.
You know, well, we pushed the time. Let's talk. So last time I was here, we had some conversations about types of diets and certain things that affect your body in certain ways. So one thing for African-American people is that you're visiting, you know, this is not really our homeland. We've come here and we've had to try to adapt, just like taking anything out of their own element, you got to try to make a change. So that being said, we've heard stories about the American diet and how it's been like one of the worst diets in the world. You know, it's high fats, high saturation, causes diabetes, Alzheimer's, heart disease, high blood pressure, all of these things, you know. So you know, 30, 40 years ago, you didn't hear about all these diseases and these disorders. But today we hear about it more and more. And you have to ask yourself, what kind of disease that, what is it that would cause your body to have an allergic reaction so bad that your limbs can literally fall off your body, just turn black and fall off? And that's basically what diabetes is. They can, neuropathy, they can die and fall off. And if you lose a limb, you got to understand you got veins, venules, arteries, and arterioles running through those veins, through those limbs. So one of the things we need to do, we need to understand is, first of all, your DNA ain't the same as everybody else. You can't eat the same that everybody else can eat. You just can't. Then there's a scripture that said, man must not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Now, if I just break that down to you and say, man must not live by bread alone, what is God saying to us? If all we're doing is sitting around and we're thinking that the things that we do and the things that we acquire, the things that we eat, or my compliments to the chef, or blue juicy red steak, if you think that's going to keep you healthy, you got another thought coming. The word of God has its own strength. It can sustain you. If you read back in history, the Hebrew Israelites wandered around out in the desert for 40 years. And they weren't hungry. So that mindset that we got to eat everything, that mindset that you got to put everything in your mouth or do what everybody else do, that's a bogus mindset. I'm sorry, y'all. I got a bird clock. That's my clock going out. I mean, you know, I'm a naturalist, so I'm a tree hugger. But anyway, so, you know, as children of Israel and coming from sub-Saharan desert and coming and being scattered into different lands, we shouldn't be trying to do what everybody is trying to do. Our God gave us specific rules on what to eat. Talked about the kud. If you don't know these things, go back and familiarize yourself with God. Talk about the kud, with the animals that eat the kud, what you should eat and what you shouldn't eat. It's all in Leviticus. What's clean and what ain't clean. I don't really have to get into all of that. But and you don't really have to believe it. But if you look around, you see diseases and disparities everywhere. So that being said, there are certain things that are just made in the lab, that if I put it in your body's not going to react well to it. One of those things is saturated fats. People talk about, well, you know, I got high cholesterol and I got high blood pressure and, you know, I got my heart, I need a heart stent. No. Well, all of those items I just named come from saturated fats. It's very seldom that, you know, that we do have cases that where hereditary plays a part, but usually the culprit is the American diet. And you know, if you just went to a restaurant and you bought a three-course meal, you know one of them was something in there, saturated fat or fried or french fries or something. Not to pick on anybody, but you know something in there. So first of all, you don't know what they cooked it in. Second of all, you really don't know what kind of meat it is. Third of all, every french fry looked the same. So our mindset of going into these places and letting somebody else cook for us is a bad mindset. You don't know what I'm putting in your food. I don't wash my hand. I got COVID. Fecal matter under my fingernail because I just left the bathroom. I could have coughed over it, anything. So you're going in and out of these institutions, and some of these institutions are fine institutions. Let me get a cappuccino with strawberry cheesecake with fondue and, you know, all of that, and it sounds real good rolling off the tongue. But if somebody told you was eating poison, you wouldn't do it. Or some of us would, because we know some of this stuff is no good. I went today, I was riding with a friend, and they wanted to get this high dollar coffee, this place, and they bought it down. I said, give me one of them. And when I got the coffee, it was just water with two black shots of extra espresso and cocoa and some ice. It's like, are you kidding me? I mean, I couldn't even drink it. I paid it like $8-$9. She paid $8-$9 for it. I was like, I don't want that. I'm sorry, I owe you $8, you know. I paid. But
you know, I was gonna say how much you paid for it, $10. I was almost right. Yeah. $8.
So your body gets this stuff inside of it and you start to experience what we call reactions or some type of response. Bloating and nausea and diarrhea and I feel like I'm gonna throw up. I got this cramping in my chest right here and gas and all of these side effects that your body's trying to tell you, do not eat this anymore. Oh, I got a headache when I ate that. Don't eat that no more. Now, as a religious people, the Most High told us don't eat pork. You don't have to argue with me on that. I ain't Muslim. I ain't none of that. I'm just telling you what he said. And if you don't serve that, that's on you. Keep eating it. It's the new white meat. All these dyes and Doritos, and I'm just naming a few just because, you know, these red dyes and yellow dyes. We're putting all this stuff in our body, and we don't never stop to think that there's green substance that grow right out the ground out there that you can eat every day. And it's not going to give you cholesterol. There's going to be no oils, no fats, no none of that. There are certain things in this country that has been genetically modified. They say it's to feed the people. I don't know. But tonight I'm going to hit on a few of the hot ones.
Milk. I got a question before you go. Started. I remember last time we spoke to you, you said that you was talking about what, like, the different oils we should be cooking with. And so, you know, I know we didn't have a lot of time, so now we have the time to get more into that. So what would you suggest as far as our cooking oils, what we should be using when we're cooking? And also to go along with that too, I remember when we were kids, we were actually cut the french fries out with the potato, you know, from the potato and fry them, you know. And so it was funny because I mentioned that to my daughter. She looked at me weird. We never done that. You know, I've never done that now as an adult, but I remember doing that. And so it just goes along with what you're saying. Like, we have reverted back into letting people cook for us. But go ahead.
So let's start with the potato. I'm looking at it right here. MyHealth at clevelandclinic.org. What are the harmful effects of eating potatoes? Atopic dermatitis, itchy rashes all over the body, vomiting, bloodstained diarrhea, dehydration, hypothermia, low blood pressure, and lethargy, where you're drowsy or sick, and asthma. These are common side effects of the potato. Just about every meal you buy, they're going to give you a genetically modified potato.
Yes.
It's not even a real potato. The sweet potato is about the only potato you need to fool with. No blue ones, no black ones, no purple ones, no white ones. The sweet potato is the only one that's loaded full of nutrients. So that's one thing. That's the potato. You can scratch that off your menu. Stop going to these places giving me a large fry, because you're not really eating large fry. You're eating a large box or something. But it ain't a fry. The other one we were talking about, the cooking oil.
Yes.
So we're just talking about saturated oil. Here I am again, National Institute of Health. Eating too much saturated fats in your diet can raise bad LDL cholesterol in your blood, which can increase the risk of heart disease and stroke. Now, that don't sound bad because you've heard that all your life. But think about how long you've been eating fried food and fried oil. That when your favorite restaurant that you go to, you don't know how often they change their oil. You don't know when the last, you don't know if roaches over in their oil. You don't know if cockroaches take a bath in there at nighttime and they reheat him back up and he settled to the bottom. And you're eating all kinds of poison. You know, I give you this graphic picture to let you know that if you eat your food, you don't know what you eat. So, saturated fats is a known killer. That's the only thing that's going to stop them arteries up. That's the only thing going to put you on high cholesterol. Excuse me. That's the only thing. That you get that from animal fat. And the scripture says something about eating animal fat. A little lamb here and there and a little wine, but nobody told you to touch that bovine now, that hoof. That bovine is a nasty fella. And that pig, Even the Christ told the pig to go off into the water.
I have something to say, cousin. So, Dr. Howard, remember when you was a kid and your parents made you like pour the grease out that they had like fried chicken or something mm-hmm. like that? And they told you, don't put the grease in my sink. Don't put the grease in my toilet because it clogs up the sink and it clogs up the toilet. So you got to think about it. If they tell you don't put that stuff in the sink or in the toilet, why would you put that type of oil in your body?
Yeah.
So here's another way to think of it. You know what it does to a pipe if you put it over in a pipe and stop it up. Your body has warm, bloody tissue with veins and venules in it that's soft, that absorbs anything that touches those blood vessels, it absorbs. And then you pour a pile of that good cold grease in there in your body. Mm-hmm. And you're expecting your heart to do something different when the particles break loose and float around, because a drop of blood going to go from the heart all the way down to the foot, all the way back down to the other foot, and going to come back to the heart on the other side. So you're putting all of this stuff in your body, which is what we're talking about. And in combination, it's deadly. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, your legs falling off, your toes falling off, your feet falling off. You got high blood pressure. You can't bend over because you done got dizzy. It's just too much. So last time I told you fruits and vegetables are good for you, but you should eat fruits in the morning. A few nuts, but you know, I hate to be the bearer of bad news to y'all, but if you wouldn't eat so much and if you sit down and meditate and think a little bit more and speak to higher powers, you can get healthy. But as long as you're going up there to your favorite restaurant and you dumping that in there where they cooking roaches and deep frying roaches with their chicken, how many times you seen flies all over the place?
Yeah. Yeah.
The lady at the desk got a bad attitude, and you know it don't taste right when you leave, and you just spend $25, and you're like, why did I do that? And we keep doing it. And keep in mind, you ain't from around here now. You from Sub-Sahara. You eating what they eat, and you're going to get what they get. So, cooking oils, you should probably switch to coconut oil, olive oil, or avocado oil. These are pure oils from vegetables. They just digest better in your body. What can I say? When it comes to cuts of meat, you ought to stay with a little lamb product. Kind of get away from that bovine. That cow ain't all that healthy. That dairy, you're not a cow. You should not be drinking this milk. You don't drink snake milk. You don't drink horse milk. You don't drink dog milk. So stay away from cow milk. Now, if you don't drink almond milk, that's one thing. Or coconut milk. I don't do cashew milk because I'm allergic to cashews and nuts. And that's another thing we need to do. If you can find somebody to do what they call a food intolerance test. And that intolerance tells you exactly what you're allergic to. There's probably been things you've been eating for years that you didn't know that you were allergic to. You need to find that out. I'm not talking about where they prick your back and find out about your seasonal allergies. We're talking about food allergies now, food intolerance. So dairy is a big issue. That's milk, cheese, yogurt. They got us so fooled, this yogurt. There's no probiotics almost at all in yogurt.
Really? I'm not disputing that, but because like you said, we've been told yogurt is the end all be all, right? So if you're going to go that route, yogurt would be the best choice to go. But explain why you said that. Explain that.
Well, it's dairy. And I already told you what dairy does for you. Dairy is not good for your body. You're going to experience stomach pain, bloating, gas. You can't really, when your body's lactose intolerant, that's your body trying to tell you something, sir. You don't need dairy. You're not a cow. So, you know, they told us at one time we're putting vitamin D in milk. Well, if you were in Sub-Saharan Africa, you wouldn't need vitamin D in milk because you'd get it from the sun. But yep. You're not at home.
Yes.
So we're going to play like we're going to give it to you in your milk. Vitamin D comes from the sun, you know, through photosynthesis and that kind of stuff. You don't get it through. So what are you putting in my milk to call it vitamin D? Are you adding a vitamin to it? What are you really doing here? So it causes inflammation, and inflammation is a acidic environment for your body. You know, I don't really want to get into all that because it's about chemistry, but there's an acidic environment, there's an alkaline environment. The alkaline environment is where you want to thrive at because acidic causes all these diseases and cancers and all this other stuff. So if you're eating foods and high in acids, you need to change it to alkaline. Vegetables, all of the green and red vegetables. I just fixed a salad a few minutes ago. I had 2-3 different types of salad in there. I had yellow peppers, red peppers, orange peppers. I go get the Purdue Farm chicken, and I'm not, you know, saying Purdue Farm is the best chicken, but I get the non-steroid, non-antibiotic, no antibiotics ever, you know. If I'm gonna eat turkey bacon, it's gonna be Applegate, no antibiotic ever, none of that. So you have to pay, you get less bacon for $5 to $7, but you don't need but 2 slices if you eat it right, you know. So
right,
saturated fats need to go, the dairies need to go, the saturated oil in those cooking, that stuff, we need to eliminate that. Broccoli, spinach, greens, salads, kale, sweet potatoes. Be careful with fruits like bananas that's high in sugar. Be careful with all those high in sugar fruits. Early in the daytime is when you need to eat that, not mostly late at night. So diet plays an important part, is what I want to tell you. And you can start today. And we talked about grains last time. You know, these grains, whole grains, with you're not a horse, basically. Your body can't digest it like a horse. They tell you, oh, it sounds good, it's gonna dry you out, it'll get, you know, provides fiber and yada yada. Yeah, you need a little fiber, just like you need a little oil. But you don't need a whole heck of a lot of fiber, because I promise you, if you're eating turnip greens or spinach or kale, you getting fiber.
I have a question for you. Some people say that corn has no nutritional value. What do you have to say about that?
Corn has been marked as one of these things that's been genetically modified. They feed, you know, and I'm not here to prove or disprove that. I'm just telling you what they say. Okay. And that corn is fed to the cows, the horses, the pigs, the chickens. And so corn is not what it used to be when it was maize. It ain't that same corn. It's a different corn. It's grown somewhere. So that's the issue with corn. And it's a grain. And those grains are just not really that healthy for us.
So should we be eating corn or popcorn?
Popcorn is corn.
I know. So I hear people say that you should not eat either of them. So I was just asking.
I don't. Okay. I don't eat either one of them because I know a lot of people that suffer from diverticulitis, from those shucks getting into the gut and into the intestines. It causes issues. As much as I like popcorn, I just don't eat it anymore. Okay. So, and I like popcorn. I just went to the movies last night and couldn't eat no popcorn.
What would you suggest as far as our nuts? Because you were talking about different nuts last time, about what was beneficial and what was not beneficial to
you. You know, it depends on you. Some people can eat the peanut and some people can eat the cashew. I can't. But, you know, always the walnut is always good. The black walnut, almonds are good. You know, I eat them with a little honey dusted. I eat a few pecans. Nuts is all about you. Some people have nut allergies and don't realize it, but, you know, in moderation, not too much. So, you know, if let's say you're going to eat some breakfast. If somebody put a little small strip steak on your plate, let's call that strip steak a piece of lamb. And somebody maybe gave you a little egg white for protein and 6, 7, 8 pieces of a skinny asparagus, some kind of sauteed sweet potato. That's a different difference in that diet than a large bowl of grits with cheese on top and butter in the middle and salt. 4 slabs of oink oink bacon, 2 pieces of toast that you can leave the bread outside the bag for 5 years. And it'll still look like bread when you walk back up to it. Mm-hmm. Wow. And then you put that jelly in there and shoot your blood sugar to the moon. then you fill your coffee up full of blood sugar. So, you know, I just use different brands. I'm not going to knock anybody's brand, but yeah. You just can't really sell me just I'm just not a street shopper. I'm not going to walk up. I've carefully select my food that I put in my body. I'm not going to walk up and eat what everybody else eating. I'm going to eat, even if it costs me more, I'm going to eat the healthiest portion of what it is to eat. And that's how we need to think. Stop walking up. Oh, they got a 25 pack of chicken wing for $5.99. Okay. You know, two for 20. Get to learn stuff. You know, somebody once told me it don't cost that much to go first class. Get the best cut. You know, go treat yourself and get the best cut. Well, I don't get as much with the best cut. Well, you don't need as much. You really don't need as much.
Unlearning and relearning. I think oftentimes people, they're so used to overeating to where if they're eating smaller portions, they think they're not getting enough. But if you drink more water and then you eat smaller portions, then you'll feel full. They want to get full instead of, you don't eat till you get full. You eat till, you know, you're satisfied.
Right.
It's a different.
Well, what you're looking at is the tools of marketing. We're going to supersize everything for you. We're going to give you a large fry and a large drink and everything large around here, and large piece of bread that don't turn green in 2 days. You know, large. And we all want something for free. So they play on your greed, really, on your psyche, you know, because you and then you walk around and everybody walk out of Walmart, their belly's dragging the ground. You wonder why they got diabetes, high blood pressure, and everybody look the same.
I was just going to speak to that. You can see, I know for me, from experience, I see people who look like a million bucks. They're dressed from head to toe in their clothes. They spend a lot of money on their clothes, their home, their cars. But when you look at them, you know, we talk about body shape, and I don't body shape anyway because I'm a thicker female. That's just my, you know, how I am. But I'm like, you look that great, but you can't even tie your own shoe. Your belly is hanging over your belt line. You can't walk up a flight of stairs. You're out of breath. You know, I'm like, you are dressed up heart attack walking, basically. You look, your clothes look great, but you're not healthy.
So, you know, a little moderate exercise don't hurt either. You know, that's something else we need to get back to. That'll help you get close to the Most High. Start talking to yourself. Start talking to God. Get off the internet. Get off TV. Get off your iPad. Get off these cell phones. You can't go nowhere without this stuff. But this is the exact same stuff. It's going to be as it were in the days of Noah. We're going to be acting a fool, partying and clowning, and the flood going to show up because we're not paying attention. There's a reason we've had to endure this 400 years of servitude that we're not at home. There's a reason, because there was a law that said if you do not do these things, you can start reading it in Deuteronomy 28, those that don't believe me. If you do these things, this was going to happen. But if you don't do these things, this was going to happen. And when you read that 28 and 29, you ask yourself, what group of people do you know in the world that this has happened to? Everybody else is at home. Everybody else is enjoying themselves. Everybody is what they're supposed to be. You, me, and him, and the people on this forum are probably right here in America, eat what they eat, doing what they do, enjoying what they enjoy, and you're going to get what everybody else get. The only way you're going to change yourself spiritually, mentally, and holy is to turn away from what you've been doing, get away from that internet, get away from the stuff that you got putting in your mind, and find something positive. Reach back and get that project that you want to work on and do something once a week on that project. If you're a person who can't stand to eat small right now and you work on your portion, cook you some purple hull peas, sweet potato, cabbage, turnip greens, and broccoli or Brussels sprout. Make sure everything is green. Don't put no cornbread. Don't go in there with no fried pork chop. Don't go looking for no steak. I promise you, if you load your plate with 5 cooked vegetables out the garden and eat that, you're going to feel a lot better. It's going to go through you. And after a while, and increase this right here. You got to increase this. You got to have this. That water is really important. If you can get your hands on alkaline water, drink it.
I'm just going to ask you that. What brand of water do you drink?
I don't want to recommend nobody's brand because they ain't paying me for that. Alkaline water. And you ain't nobody, you ain't famous to me till you cut me a check. So, yeah. I just drink some alkaline water. Anybody who, I don't know, you might have 5 million fans on your show tonight. I don't know. I'm just drinking water.
I'm with you.
I got a question. So how do you feel about, what is your opinion about going vegan or what do they call people that eat just fish?
Pescatarian.
What do you feel about that as far as dieting? And vegetarian. Well, how do you feel about those three?
So, you know, a lot of that stuff you're talking about is just verbiage, brother. You just talk about names, you know. The Most High has already told us what to eat. That's who you need to be following. Go back to the book and find out what he said. There's certain things we just ain't supposed to eat. And if you eat, you can eat all just about all the fish you want. I told you last time, just watch the big fish because they got mercury. But, you know, catfish and the bottom dwellers like flounder, to stay away from them because they get the most mercury. But bake your fish, grill your fish, put it in foil, put a little organic margarine on there that ain't, it's not dairy. Organic butter, you can get plant butter and all kinds of butter, so it don't have to be dairy butter. And bake it with your favorite seasoning. I use all seasoning. It's called all seasoning. It's stuff that's delicious. I put it on everything. Yeah. I put that on everything. So it is so good, you know. I can put it on egg white. Like in the morning, this morning I got up, I cooked egg white. You know, I might have some vegetables, some peppers in it, add some broccoli, throw some asparagus tips in there. Banana peppers, some green, you know, spinach, whatever. And I don't usually saute mine. I put a little olive oil in there and let it cook hard on one side and just flip it. And I got a pancake omelet. And I might eat me two strips of turkey bacon and some sweet coffee. I'm out the door. Certain coffees and certain brands offer certain protections. The kind of coffee I use is VitaCup. VitaCup has minerals and vitamins in it. So if you don't get a meal, you full till about 11 or 12 o'clock. But these other cups of coffee, you're drinking roach legs and ants and, the, you know, a lot of this stuff it comes from all over the world. So, but, you know, I don't want to sit here and act like, you know, certain brands got certain this, but it's just like anything else. You can go out and get a small compact car, or you can go get a car that'll hold five or six people. That's luxury. It's all about what you want and where you at. If you want the tightest little car, the littlest car on the market, go get you one. We got plenty of chicken to serve you out here. But if you ain't looking for non-steroid chicken with no antibiotics and hormones, you can eat the hormones. But you ought to ask yourself what's in hormones and all of that, you know.
You had a couple questions. Can you pop up, I think it's GK, pop her question up in there, Natasha's, you can put hers back up. Can you see her question?
Yeah, you're going to pay either way on the front end with Amazing Food, on the back end with hospital bills. Because I guess something be sick because you're sick or something.
Yeah.
Well, you know, hospital bills come from sometimes uncertainties in hospital bills can come from neglect. But, you know, I'm convinced that diet and exercise is the fountain of youth. Mm-hmm. You know, so is it possible that I can walk outside and a spaceship can fall and hit me on the head? Sure. Is it likely? Nah. So, is it possible that certain foods might send you to the hospital, or certain foods? Statistically, you can look these things up. You can know. You know where it's going. Ms. Natasha Dobson, alkaline water, is it good for you, and should we drink it? Yes, you should, because your body needs to maintain an alkalinity state. Diseases thrive in an acidotic state. Acidotic, 7.35 to 7.4. The normal pH is 7.35 to 7.45. Anything below 7.35 is acid. Anything above 7.45 is alkaline. And you kind of want to stand. That's why I drink a little alkaline water. You can look up foods that give you alkaline. Your body just, you know, if I can try to give you a picture of what that might look like in an acid environment, you got the, I'm just giving you a visual. This is not what's happening, but I'm just giving you a visual just to help you out. In an acidotic environment, it might look like an apple seltzer in water foaming. Mm-hmm. And you got all these secretions and all this juice and all this stuff. Well, in an alkaline environment, you just got the straight pure water. And your body just operates better. You cannot operate in all of these out of zone areas. There are different zones and different numbers that you have that you need to operate in that normal zone. Just like your blood pressure should be in a normal zone. Anything below or above, you're doing too much. And most of the time, what's causing the highs and the lows is the diet, the blood sugar spikes, or the salt intake, the sodium intake, you know. So a lot of these things you can normalize your own body. And the longer you get your body to stay in what we call homeostasis, that normal zone, the more healthier you'll be. Them ups and downs and the spikes, you don't want that. You don't want to be all week long, your blood pressure been high, then all of a sudden it's normal. Then 2 weeks later, oh, it's all high again because I've been stressed out. Well, your body's not going to work. Keep working on all that pressure. So that normal homeostasis zone is optimal, and that's where you want to be. Something else real quick, and then I'm going to let y'all talk. We talked about sleep last time. Sleep is important. Sleep and rest is important. You cannot get enough sleep around here. I know you're used to running on 5 hours and thinking you're Superwoman and Superman, but slow down, get back with the Most High. Find your favorite watering hole where you watch large bodies of water. If you ain't impressed by God, go sit out by a large body of water or go hang your feet off the back of a cliff. I guarantee you, you're going to see his awesomeness. So get in that time, get in that crunch time, meditate if it ain't 10 or 15 minutes a day. Get in your shower every morning, meditate before you go to work. That's not meditating. Getting up and sitting on your couch for 10 or 15 minutes and read a scripture for the day, that might be. But get back in that, dedicate a little time to yourself, dedicate a little time to a higher power, and try to eat right and add a little exercise. It's work-life balance. It's all about balance. Unfortunately, we don't get the amount of sleep and rest we need because we rip and run. We got to go pick so-and-so up. We got to drop the kids off. I'm running late for work. We ain't got but 5 days. Last weekend, we went out of town. My girlfriend's called me. We went to the party. I'm still sleeping from that. So sleep is important. And those of you that who've not had a sleep study, if you snore at all, if anybody has ever said you snore, go get a sleep study. Because you could be potentially cutting off your oxygen. And if you do that for year after year after year, it's going to cause some issues. High blood pressure, stroke, aneurysm. There's a lot of things that sleep can do to you that you can avoid if you just go and get yourself checked out. So that's kind of why I am with that.
I was going to ask, how do you feel about beans? Lima beans, pinto beans, black eyed peas? How do you feel about beans, period? String beans?
I think beans are good. You know, Brother Farrakhan got something to say about beans, and some other doctors got some beans, say something about beans. But I eat a few beans. You know, I eat a few peas, purple hulls, and butter beans or something like that. Like if I make me a medley, little olive oil in the plate, I take some frozen butter beans. I don't even put them in water. I put them over there in that olive oil, throw some peppers in it, cut some onion up on them, saute them with a little, my favorite all seasoning. Throw some chicken in there and grill it. I might throw a little red meat in there and grill it, whatever. I might throw a few shrimp in there if I wanted to, but I wouldn't eat shrimp with beans. But the point is, you can just mix it up, you know. And it's a sprout. So, you know, you have to don't overdo it with them sprouts. That's what I did say about that, you know. So, but beans, I eat them. Now, you know, do your own research on them. It may not work for you. If you're getting all that flatulence, and people are like, oh my God, was that you? Man, you don't need to eat that, man. You know, so it's all about what your body say to you.
My friend said your combination. She said that sounds good. The beans and the, how you mix it up.
Yeah, I mean, I take butter beans and take a few butter. I cut a few green beans, a few butter beans and white beans, and put them in a skillet and just turn it on low and simmer them with onion and bell pepper. And I promise you, the medley is so good, you know. A little garlic clove or something, and then I'll take and get me some something else on the side, or mix it in there and eat it up. And that's a whole meal. You don't, again, you don't have to sit down and eat the bread on top of the hamburger. And you don't say, you go get that buttermilk chicken sandwich over there. You know what it's gonna taste like, and you know what's in it. You know the place over there where everybody got the line wrapped around the corner, that old sweet buttermilk chicken they got. On every corner. You know who got that old buttermilk sweet chicken everybody want to go get every Saturday morning?
Yeah. Oh, I have to ask you a question. What about the tomato?
Oh, yes.
Tomatoes have gotten a lot of flack because tomatoes got acid in it. The word is that they've been kind of genetically modified, that they're not the same anymore. So, you know, I don't fool with a lot of them. Let's see what... let's see what WebMD say about it. Y'all get your calculator out.
Okay.
WebMD and tomato. What are side effects of the tomato? Skin discoloration, digestive troubles, body aches, and acid reflux. Acid reflux is going to be your number one, along with chocolate, peppermint, any kind of spices and pepper that's going to give you acid reflux. And a lot of people had that. And they throw up in the back of their throat, they throw up in their mouth, and they burp to throw up. And, you know, so it's a lot of, yeah.
Yeah, one of my friends, I actually had lunch with her the other day, and she was telling me that she woke up out of her sleep, you know, vomiting from acid reflux. And, you know, I told her it was something that she had ate. And some people died because they vomit in their sleep and they don't wake up from it. So.
What? How do you feel about lemons and
cucumbers? Now you're talking about alkaline.
Yeah. Okay.
So these alkaline products are good for you.
I drink a lot of water with, I actually got one right now, but I have a pitcher and I always drink it with lemon, cucumber, and the mint leaves. And so sometimes what end up happening, I'll leave it in the refrigerator and it'll freeze sometimes. But yes, I drink that every day.
So then my wife, she can't even eat lemon because she's allergic to citrus.
Really?
I mean, I can start peeling an orange in the room and her airways go to closing up. Hmm. So it's all about what's, you know, how your body's reacting to certain things. And it's about moderation too. You know, don't overdo any of it. You can drink lemon water, but every once in a while, drink some cranberry. The Bible even tell you every once in a while, take your swig of wine. It helps with the gut. Probiotics, these probiotic drinks, I drink some of them sometime, they help with the gut. One of your major issues is your gut. You ought to be cleaning your gut quite often. And I'm not talking about, that's your cesspool, to be honest with you. I'm not talking about with, what's that old chocolate candy grandmama used to give us? X-Lax.
Oh.
I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about go to your GI doctor, get him to do a colonic wash and a colonic cleaning, get your GI tract checked, and then once you get clean, you know, stop eating it. If you're a person who constipated all the time, I promise you, if you drink enough water, water can bust through concrete. No matter, my first case study when I started in healthcare was at Meharry Medical School. I'll never forget it. There was a woman, I had to do a critical care rotation. There was a woman and a surgeon was in there working on this woman. And she had fecal impactions. Mm-hmm. And buddy, he had her legs cocked up in the air and a silver pan on the floor. And he was picking these pebbles and they were hitting the pan like rocks. Ping, 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 and she out of it. And he's sitting there in the room is, oh my God, smell. But this is the case. So increase your water intake. Get off these old sugary juices, all these orange juices and pineapple juice. That stuff ain't no good for you. You're not squeezing your own orange. You're not squeezing your own pineapple. You're eating what they call it's pasteurized. Mm-hmm. That's a whole nother thing. Water, 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 water. You can't drink enough. You drink enough, you quit eating so much.
I got a question because we have, you know, me being an older male, 40s, and so the conversation with some of us is called, some of us are afraid, right? Colonoscopy. Am I pronouncing it correct? Colonoscopy.
Colonoscopy. Colonoscopy, yes.
Yes. Can you, do you have any information on why it's important? Or can you speak to that?
Stomach cancer is one of the most aggressive cancers, man. So, I'd like to give you a visual. Imagine your stomach as being an intestine that's a hollow, meaty tube with veins and venules, arterioles and arteries that runs through this meaty tube. And you put something in there on this thin piece of tissue and just let it lay there. I'm just giving you an analogy here. Just let it lay there. Well, because of the pressure that's in there, it's cutting off the blood flow. If it cut off the blood flow to that spot long enough, that tissue would die. If that tissue die, you got a hole there, or you got something. So that's a visual of why you need to keep your gut clean. It's a clean pipe. Nothing needs to sit there for years. You eat a piece of meat and you don't digest it right, and all you eating is meat, 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 and you ain't drinking no water, and you pack all this meat in there and all this cholesterol, eventually your body gonna say, whoa, 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 whoa. And you hear me saying this, but you don't realize how long it's been since you've had a total cleaning out all the way from top to bottom. Because it takes you to food 2-3 days, 4 days, sometimes meat longer than that.
Ground beef, 48 hours.
That's my point.
Yes.
So, you know, and guess what? You'll be eating again in about 8 hours.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
You're going to eat something. What did you have tonight?
Oh, me? Yeah. I had some pizza earlier. But before that, I had some spinach, and my wife cooked spinach with some eggs. So, like, I'm big on the green
food. What was on the pizza?
What was on the pizza? Pepperoni, sausage, onion, and cheese.
What'd you eat for breakfast?
The spinach and eggs. Spinach, eggs, and I have my alkaline water.
So you had one animal for breakfast, which was the egg.
Yeah.
What'd you eat for lunch? The pizza again?
The pizza, yep. The pepperoni, sausage, and onion pizza.
So you had a pig, that's another animal. And what's your third meal?
I ate, I'm good.
For okay.
Yeah.
So you had two different animals today. Now, you better ask, you know, you look like a brother who's conscious. You better ask yourself why, when we left the Saharan desert, we were instructed not to eat the pig. And I eat a little pig every once in a while. I had some bacon 2-3 days ago, but I'm conscious of it.
Yeah.
You know, so you didn't eat two pigs. You ate bacon and sausage. Why didn't you get something else, you know, a little bit less fatter? Pay for the salmon. Pay for the chicken, the high grade of chicken, the breast. Now, chicken, you got to understand, causes a lot of mucus. I don't know what they putting in these chicken, but chicken, if you notice, when you eat 4 or 5 pieces of chicken, or next time you eat some chicken, watch how much mucus you have in your airway you're spitting up the next morning. And just pay attention.
What's interesting, too, right after the broadcast, the last show you was on, my wife went out and bought the Purdue chicken strips. And so they sitting in the refrigerator now. And so that's why I was going to cook tomorrow, as we talk about preparation. Yes, I like to try to, you know, I'm busy, but I like to prepare my meals. And so I'm very conscious of what I'm, you know, putting my body, because I believe that is a temple. You have to take care of it, just like you take care of your mind, you know, working out and everything else, finances, trying to take care of your body. So she took heed to that. As soon as you talked about those chicken strips Purdue, I looked on the list and it was actually in the shopping bag, and so there's some there. So
there you go. So and Purdue is not the only one. There's some other grades out here. You know, you pay a little bit more for it, but you worth it. You worth it. You know. And like the guest said the first time, you can pay on this end or you can pay on the back end. On the back end, you ain't gonna have the strength to recover though.
I have a question, since Amaru kind of brought it up about, you know, males and colonoscopy, male and female need that. Some of our friends that we kind of grew up with and went to school with, they still believe that they're young. So when I have these conversations with them about making sure they do their prostate exam, they kind of feel like they don't need to. I'm like, I think they changed it. Like, what age is it now for males to go and get the prostate exam? Isn't it in their 40s?
You know, they changed it so much, but you know, prostate exam is not like they used to be. They don't stick their fingers where they don't belong anymore. They draw blood now. So, you know, why not, you know, go get it done if you need it done. So, I can tell you the age here. Hold on. Let's see. That's so beautiful about this thing. You can look this up. It says 55. Starting at 55, you need a PSA screen between the age of 40 and 54.
Okay, that's what I thought. So 40 and 54, but again, some of the guys that kind of grew up with me, you have that conversation with them. They kind of like, oh, I'm not old enough for that. Actually, you are, sir. You just kind of feel like you're still young, but you're in your 40s. Make sure you're getting your wellness check. A lot of them won't be able to decline physicals, decline getting a wellness check. You know, just because they feel like they look healthy on the outside, they won't go and get those annual checkups. In the last year, Amaru can kind of vouch for this. Just this year alone, I think we've lost maybe, if they didn't go to high school with us, they still were from Gary. So I know them because Gary's like one big family. I can probably sit here and say probably since January, we lost maybe 10 classmates. You know, some of it was health issues, but other was gun violence. But still, some of these people are having strokes. They're having heart attacks. They're having all these different things, and they're just now hitting the threshold of 40 years old. I remember growing up, you wouldn't hear about a heart attack or a stroke when people, until they was, 60, 70 years old. Now they're having them at 25 and 35 and 40, you know. So that stuff now is more common than unheard of. And it's the lifestyle.
It's two things here, you know. The Most High told us to spend time with Him. And when you don't, it slowly kills you. You're going to die. If all you do is go party all the time, all you do is eat all the time, wherever your heart is, that's what you're going to get. If your heart is not into coming back and taking care of oneself and worship and eating according to what He said and living by according to rules He said live by and remembering the Sabbath, if your heart is not there, you're not going to do it. Well, if your heart is not there, then it's somewhere else and you're doing something else. If you're doing that something else, it may kill you. You know, you it's your lifestyle. You want to go to the club every Friday night and go eat the chicken wings they got over there and drinking all the beer and you do that every night, you're going to get that. You know, but if you the kind of say, you know what, I think I need to prep my meals, put me some broccoli in this bowl, pan sear me some asparagus in this bowl, cream me up some sweet potatoes in this bowl, and get it ready for tomorrow, and then prepare for your what you need to be doing, not only just homework or lesson, but that dream that you want to start your own business and go on the internet and do an hour of that every day, then you start becoming in a conscious state and you start building a dream and building that goal. But if all you do is what the internet say do and what Jay-Z and them got going on, or you listening to Trump and Biden and all of this stuff, it is a smokescreen, a distraction.
Yes.
And while you caught up, it's going to be as it were in the days of Noah. You're going to be somewhere clowning, having a good time. You're going to get caught with your pants down. Period.
Okay. So
and one last thing. Before, in the days of Noah, Moses, it had never rained. They ain't never seen rain. So they wouldn't have never expected a flood. The point is, you know, the Bible says that when He comes back, if you look back, you ain't even fit for the kingdom of heaven. Now you think about what you're leaving behind. Wife, kids, children, home, cars, Bill Gates. had one of the worst cancers you can buy. He said he couldn't get nobody. He couldn't pay nobody to take that off of him. So you can get caught up in this world, and there are no absolutes. You still may die from living a good, clean life. But statistically, when you clean yourself up and start trying to live right and exercise and diet, you do a little bit better statistically. And some may have died and may not even gotten to it, but statistically, you can do a little bit better.
I have a comment to a couple. So it's interesting that you talk about meditation, because I had a meeting with someone, important meeting, and you know, politician there, and you know, we're in this holistic space, right? And so I thought it was interesting that she started off by having us meditate for 15 minutes. And she, you know, she's talking about the colors and all that. So, and it was funny because the politician, he was just like, what? You know, like, you know, and she's talking about meditation and, you know, just having that mental capacity to like to slow down and think and let those stresses, you know, fall from yourself. So I think that's key for also, I have a comment too. So, well, question, how do you feel about beer? Because, I know a lot of our classmates and people my age who are drinking a lot of beer. And so I don't know, like, and I get it, right? You want to go out?
I'm going to tell the truth. They drinking beer, and I hear the cocaine is the new marijuana. So
I'm just saying, they doing a lot of substance, right? And so when you talk about how damaging this stuff is to your body, because I don't know if it's just plain ignorance or just not paying attention. Or just like you said, or just plain ignorance. So, can you speak about that from a physician's perspective?
Well, I'm not a physician. I'm a PhD.
PhD. I'm sorry.
Beer. And I'm gonna name a few more things: cocaine, crack, rat poison, bleach. Beer is made from a grain, all right? It's an alcoholic beverage. It's just a moldy, fermented type of a process. So you have to ask yourself, how is your body going to handle that? It has an effect over your body. I promise you it does. And I can go down this road and show you 1,000 people that it has made homeless. And I can show you 1,000 people that... who do all right with a beer. The point is, you got to look at yourself. And having a man asked Sigmund Freud about a cigar. He said, Mr. Freud, you sitting there telling us about the oral fixation and everything, but you got the nerve to smoke a cigar. And Sigmund Freud said, sir, a cigar sometimes is just a cigar. Same thing with a beer. A beer sometimes is just a beer. But if you got to have a 24-pack when you get up, all day long, or you got to smoke weed before you go to work, while you're at work, when you're on break, and come home, smoke some more, get up and do the same thing. When do you detox? When do you clear your mind and clear your body from the stuff you're putting in it? You could sit there and eat turnip greens all day, every day, if you wanted to. There are no absolutes. If you do it, you're going to get a result from this stuff. So, moderation, I ain't knocking a beer. We know what grain can do for you, just like we know what what tobacco do for you. But if you have a cigar, I'm not going to condemn you for smoking a cigar. I'm just saying, if you sit there and smoke cigars and inhale them too much for 20 years, there's going to be an expected result from that. So it's moderation. Have your beer. If you got to have one every Saturday night, you ought to ask yourself why. Same thing with cigarettes. If you smoking cigarettes and you smoke one a day, and you say, I don't need but one a day, I'm good. But if you smoking a whole pack a day, what's it, 25 in a pack? How many cigarettes you smoking an hour? I always tell my patient, if you smoke, I'll smoke a half a pack a day. Well, how many half pack? Oh, about 12. Okay, well, you ain't up but 8-10 hours. So you smoking one every hour? Smoke one every 2-3 hours until you get yourself to where you need to be. I ain't saying just quit. And this stuff takes prayer and supplication, man, because these vices have been placed upon us to create a product. And we bury our real emotions under these vices of cigarettes and beer and cocaine. And that's secondary to what's really going on. What's really going on is that you ought to be taking your time talking to God. A wise man told me, even if you're smoking crack, you ought to be praying and asking God to take that crack pipe away from you. So, I ain't got no heaven or hell to put you in. I ain't going to judge you about no beer, no tobacco, or no cigar. I'm just saying, look at your life, shape off the rough edges, and try to clean yourself up, because you have to present yourself back to God. And he didn't put you here with all that stuff on you. He didn't put you here drunk. He ain't put you here. You're a king. You're away from home. It's a foreign land for you. You ain't got no business over here drunk all the time. What kind of problems you got? Just hang on till Yahshua come back. You know, you're a king. You're going home.
That's right.
You over here, they let you down at the castle. You down here in the barn walking around on sheep manure and horse manure, and you doing what they do. Mm. You still a king.
Wilding in the pen with the
pigs. Yeah, you're still a king. Carry yourself like that. Don't learn to say no thank you. Don't eat everything they put in front of you. Don't drink everything they put in front. Oh, I take that's an apple martini with a great goose and scotch. Man, stop trying to be fancy. Stop trying to be.
I got a question. I just thought about it, too. How do you feel about apple cider vinegar?
Apple cider vinegar is a healing property. You can research thousands of healing properties with apple cider vinegar. The apple is a powerful tool.
I use it for my hair and I drink it. But when I try to dilute it in my water. But someone told me that if you drink it so much of it, it stains your teeth.
So does coffee.
Yes, that's what I told him. That's exactly what I told him.
Little baking soda, stop using these old poison toothpaste. Little baking soda and peroxide to clean your teeth so white and pretty you won't even know it. Mm-hmm. You know, that Colgate, I don't mean to call no name, but some of these toothpastes got some stuff in it you don't want. That fluoride is not good for you. You can look it up. Mm-hmm. Fluoride is not healthy for you. So, you know, again, I ain't here to close down the food industry. I'm just telling some of us that we need to do a little bit better, eat a little bit better, exercise a little bit more, cut back on some of your old habits, because your habits can keep you from your growth.
Dr. Ben Howard, I love the way that you said that, you know, just because you're away from home does not take away that you're still a king and a queen. Oftentimes we forget that just because we're like you moved away from your parents. I moved away from my parents, but it does not mean that we still didn't have the tools that they gave us. Just because we're not in our native land does not mean that we're not still kings and queens and that we shouldn't act as such. But people, they forget that. So I love that you said that. And we talk about diet. Diet is not just what you put into your body. You keep saying that. It is also what you see, and it's also what you let enter into your earways. And
so
your diet is what you see, what you eat, and who you have around you. And oftentimes people follow the trend. They follow the fad. Whoever they're hanging around, they become like chameleons. They're changing up who they are just because of the circle that they continue to hang around in. You know, certain environments is just not for you. I know I don't hang with everybody. I don't talk to everybody. I don't think I'm better than people. It's just certain places I will not go to and certain things I will not do.
Music too. Music, diet too. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah, you cannot, if you follow the masses of the people, it's going to be as it were in the days of Noah. You cannot follow the masses. There are a lot of souls out here that are lost. So just all I can say to you again is start getting you a spiritual group, a Sunday school group where you buy a Sunday school book and y'all read that book and try to understand what the scripture means. A lot of this stuff is not really all that corny. You know, it's really instructions. And if you, like right now, the American Negro has gotten off on following the religion of people who doctored or altered the document. And if you look at Egypt or you look at Kemet or any of those black towns on the Nile, all of the hieroglyphics, the skin is dark. Mm. So now all of a sudden, no more of them dark people in there. They beige now.
They whitened up Nefertiti. I say she was pale white. I was like, wow. They bathed.
So what happened to the people who were there? Oh, they were scattered. And when they wasn't at home, somebody went and occupied the place and said, well, we from here. Well, where they at? Them 12 tribes, they went there, and there. Well, the Most High said, in 400 years, I'm coming back for my people. You got my jewel. You got my jewelry in your bosom, and I want it back. I want it back. I want my man back. He coming back home.
This so, is the four corners of the earth?
We need to wake up.
Yes.
And realize somebody is going to come back for us. And that we belong to somebody. We don't belong here. And I promise you, if you read Deuteronomy 28, 29, just read, start reading Deuteronomy, it'll tell you who you are. The Bible ain't lying. We scattered, though, to those four corners. But we belong to somebody. And yeah, we're getting mistreated and beat because he told us that's what's going to happen to you if you get over there and start worshiping their God. And I need to say, Sunday is a day that we've all been taught was the day of worship. Sunday, S-U-N, is the first day of the week. Saturday is the Sabbath. Next time you sitting around on Sabbath, watch and feel how much peace and comfort come over you on Saturday morning around 9, 10, 11, or 12 o'clock. Once you get up out your bed on Saturday morning, watch and see how peaceful you feel. Sunday, come back around, you know your ass when you go back to work. Because it's the first day of the work week.
So we have to close out. So we're going to do the eye candy, and then we're going to do our ending remarks. But we are so grateful and so thankful for you to come on. I think it's a really good show. I love the questions that Maru asked, the questions that I had to share. And I'm so grateful for the information. That was really dope. Thank you so much.
If I have to leave y'all with anything, go get your sleep study. Go get your colonoscopy. If you're feeling kind of short of breath or feeling any kind of heart issues, go get your stress test. Go get these little tests. It's better to know that you don't have HIV. Now you know you can live until the next encounter. You know? The point here is, if you know, you good until the next encounter. So be careful and go check it out and find out the truth about yourself. Clear your mind. You won't have to worry, then you won't have to guess.
Well, you know what? I have to say this since you brought that up. And it's kind of been over social media. All of these men and women, there are sister wives, and all of these men, they want all of these wives, and they don't want to be with one woman. They don't want to be single. I mean, they want to be single. They don't want to get married, but everybody wants, is it polygamy? Yeah. So I don't know what that's about. I do think
I'll tell you what it's about. It's an agenda that this elite group of people have pushed off on the Israelites. You're not that person. Mm. That's not who you are. You're a king and a queen.
I keep saying that the
black nobody.
Black if you, I'm like, how are y'all accepting of this?
If you're following that doctrine, is as it were in the days of Noah. That's not who you are. You're doing what they do. Keep shaking your booty. Keep gyrating. Keep pulling it open. Keep selling it. Somebody gonna keep buying it. And then one day you're gonna look up and you're gonna see a softball sized sore on the side of your body with pus draining out of it. And then you're gonna see some green fall out and crawl out of it. Then you're gonna go to praying to God, asking God to deliver you. You weren't asking God to deliver you when you was having a good time. Refrain from this. Cut back, pull back. Stop going down there doing what they're doing down there in the valley. When Moses came back from the mountaintop, they down there partying. When I left you, you weren't partying. You down here drinking, getting high, the bull on fire, you kicking it. And you just were saved. I just saved you from a catastrophe. So, you know, our people got to understand who we are. Queen up, king up. When I speak to young black men, I see these black men, they look at me funny. I'm 6'6", 250. They look at me funny. First thing I say is, how you doing, king? Because that's who I'm talking to. Me and this dude is from another country over here. I ain't got no business talking to him bad and talking, looking at his wife. And kings don't do that. That's how wars start. You get your own, you take care of your own, and you let God bless you through the man down through your family and disseminate that. But if you want to do what everybody else doing and partying and shaking and gyrating and jumping and popping and pop locking and popping pills. And
that's all the girls doing now.
You know what they're doing?
They twerking. That's like the thing now. Just twerking.
I saw something where it was a young lady being interviewed, and she said, real quickly, she's like, "Yeah, I love two guys having me because I'm a goddess. I need to be worshipped." I was like, "Wow," you know, like it floored me. But it's like you said, like that's the lifestyle you want to live.
Listen. It's about choice. You got two choices. You can't have one master and serve the other. You got choices. You got to pick a team. You got to pick a side. It's that simple. Mm-hmm. You will pick a side. Every knee going to bow and every tongue going to confess either way. But you going to pick a side. The side you pick, you better hope you're right. It don't cost nothing except Christ's blood. You ain't got to have nothing for Christ. If you accept and say, okay, I accept the teachings of the Bible and I accept Christ as the gift from God. Really, that's all you paid right there was that word. You ain't paid nothing. He took the stick to the side and he dropped the blood and he took the pain. All you doing is announcing to the spirit world that I'm with this other team over here.
Yeah.
I ain't on that team.
Yeah.
And I don't do what y'all do. I don't gyrate and bump. I mean, what are you doing? You selling something?
Dry hump it.
I mean, if you selling a little something, we buying a little something. Now that I know that you're a deal, I'll buy something. But that's all it is. I got this saying, I got a famous saying, you can't sell me nothing, but I buy what I want. You know, if I like it, I buy it. So, you know, if you got somebody who's gyrating and somebody who's stripping, they might be needing some money. Because there's somebody who will buy it. There's somebody who buy it. You know, so it's a market for it.
Obviously.
Well,
we got to wrap up the show, but thank you again for coming. He's going to do the eye candy and then the business of the week. But I would love to have you come back on to talk about.
Because I'm getting a lot of comments to say you need to come back again.
Yes, we want to have you come back. Would you come back and talk to us about.
Hey, y'all know I'm good. Y'all know I'm good.
My mom and dad, what we want to do is like married couples to talk to us about what worked, didn't work, what worked, what doesn't work, and also like the honor that it is in marriage. I think oftentimes now people actually struggle on getting married because they feel like they're missing out on something. And they want to continue to be single, whether it's men or women, or they've had so much heartache that they don't feel like they can ever find someone that they can love or they can love them. So want to have you back on to kind of talk about that. I'm so honored that you came on. You're hilarious. Everybody seems to love you. So thank you so much.
I love my people, you know, and all of this education I done paid for, I'm willing to give it to them because I shouldn't be here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where I come from, I was counted out. I'm from Greenville, Mississippi, a little small town called Metcalf, Mississippi, where they got ditches and there used to be sewage running in the ditch. I don't live like that no more. Mm-hmm. I don't deserve to be here though. God has blessed me to come in and be able to say, hey, listen, I can tell you this for free. Now you can go to the doctor and go over there and buy them pills and they're gonna charge you for it. And each pill they give you, you'll be back in 30 days to renew it. It ain't gonna fix you. But if you want to fix yourself spiritually and holistically, you got to turn back to the Most High. You got to go back, search yourself for God, and he is in you. Listen to for that voice. He is inside of you. My people, we perish because we have a lack of knowledge. And you're not fighting against flesh and blood. You're not fighting against what you see. It's spirits and principalities in high places that are designed to destroy you. They want you dead. They don't want you to get back to heaven because God already told them, y'all can't come back, fallen angels. So he gonna take as many folks, and the bigger that deception that he has is to convince you, oh man, that ain't true no more. That's corny, man. Ain't no God, ain't no Jesus, ain't no none of this, ain't no none of that. So, you know, somebody created all this. Scientists can tell you, if you ask the scientists, they can tell you that everything in the universe is perfect. And it took a genius mind to build that everything in the universe. And you are a product. And he says about man that man is made in my image. So when you see me, you see you, and you see her, and you know that you're from Israel, and you know that this ain't your home. You know what you look like, and you know what he looked like. You don't have to, don't take a genius. You know what he looked like, you know what you look like. So we're a beautiful expression of his love, us and our kids. We ought to see your kids. You ought to see how you are in him, the way your kids treat you. It's simple, you know. But anyway, bless you guys. I love y'all, man. Call me back. We'll talk. I'll be glad to talk about marriage. I had a couple of them too. Yeah, so you know, that partnership thing, it takes some work.
Someone says bless you.
Yeah, thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ben Howard. I just love you, and we would love to have you back on. So we'll send you updates when we're gonna have you come back on the show. I think he's frozen. Okay. Yeah, he'll pop up the eye candy for we can wrap it up, and then the business of the week.
So this is eye candy real quick. That was so funny. Your cousin's hilarious.
Mm-hmm. And my whole family's like that.
And so this is the eye candy. I'll let you describe, because this is your same. So go ahead.
All right. So here is the eye candy of the week, or should I say month. This is a pair of Chanel shoes, the Chanel bag. It's an Ascart for you guys, for ladies that like to wear Ascarts around their neck. I mean, also some Chanel glasses. And these were a gift to me, so very appreciative. You could pair this with a black dress, ladies. If you work in the office, if you're a school teacher, a businesswoman, you can put that on and look great. So that's the eye candy.
And then we want to do the black, well, not entrepreneur from a business, but it's the same thing, black entrepreneur of the day. And I'll let you speak on this.
Okay, so I actually ran into this young lady. She is a lockstress here in Indianapolis. So if anyone is local and they are looking for a lockstress, please contact Sydney. Here is her IG information and also her website. Very personable young lady, and she's really good at what she does. So that is our entrepreneur of the week.
Yes, and so obviously, again, if anyone has any businesses, or just anything that they like to promote, we obviously do that for free on here. And so any shout outs, Candace, as we close?
I do. I want to give a shout out to you, as always, Amaru, for being the best business partner ever. So thank you. I also want to give a shout out to my great nephew. We had his birthday party today. His birthday isn't actually until tomorrow. So shout out and happy birthday to Ari. TT loves you. I want to give a thank you to Dr. Ben Howard for actually coming on the show. He gave us some great information, some great knowledge. He gave us a couple laughs, as always. So I want to thank him. And just thank you to my parents and to my family, because, you know, it takes a lot of support to keep you pushing and keep you moving. I shared with Amaru earlier that I'm exhausted today. I've been doing I had a lot of interviews that happened. I had a lot of clients with my therapy agency. I had a baby shower last weekend. I had a birthday party this weekend. So just really been doing a lot, but I'm so thankful because it takes a team to help push you sometime into your destiny. So I'm grateful. So thank you, everyone. Friends and family, I love you all.
My shout outs would be to obviously my co-host for giving me this opportunity. So this is always cool. We work great as a team. And so I see some of the things that, you know, you have challenges with. And so for you to come every other Sunday, right? Every other week, and, you know, give great energy, right? And because this is not easy to do. People think this is so easy. This is not easy to do, right? You have to be on alert with things. You have to, you know, put things in proper order. And so I'd like to give you a shout out just for being you, right? Just being dynamic. Also, I would like to shout out who we spoke to earlier, Alex, right? Because we have conversations, which is, you know, just a nugget. We're going to be doing something a little festive for the holiday season, particularly, I can't talk today, in December, surrounding around holiday giving. And so just to keep that that idea in the air, surrounding Christmas and Kwanzaa, whichever one you celebrate, Hanukkah. I don't know who celebrates Hanukkah Black, but if you do, oh well, go ahead. I mean, a great, you know, but we're going to be in that space right around in December. And so shout out to him for reaching out to us to make that happen. And so I'm very grateful. Also, shout out to my missus. I like to also give her a shout out because I've been busy the last couple, three, 4 weeks all over the place. And so I really appreciate the support, right? The support system, because usually you wouldn't get that. Like, you leave me home with all these kids, right? But like, we got 30 kids, right? But no, she's been great. Just been flexible. So I would always want to make sure that she knows that I appreciate her. So shout out to her.
And shout out because she cooked you a healthy breakfast. You know, breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
Well, let me quick story. So I'm out here blowing these leaves, right? We got a bunch of trees. So I'm blowing leaves from the back of the house all the way to the front. It took me an hour and a half. I got the industrial leaf blower, right? And so my daughter comes out. I got headphones on. My daughter's like, "Hey, are you hungry?" I'm like, "Yeah." "Mom cooked you a breakfast." I was like, "What is it?" She was like, "Spinach and eggs." I said, "Hold on, let me go get this over with because I'm hungry." So, and I told her, I said, "I appreciate that because that's one of the things that people don't understand. When you get married, you're supposed to be a helpmate, right?" Mm-hmm. And I always talk about that. And so if you see your husband dirty in his hands and doing stuff, yard work outside the house, don't sit there and watch him do it. Be a helpmate. Give him a glass of water. Give him some lemonade. Make him a spinach and eggs breakfast, right? Do stuff like that, right? I just told her I appreciate that, you know. So that was just cool. So again, I'd like to give her a shout out. With that said, though, I'd like to transition to talk about our next podcast, which is November 27th. The topic is be surrounding holiday traditions. Obviously, we'll be coming off Thanksgiving, those who celebrate it. I call it Turkey Day. But, you know, we just asking questions. What did you do for the holiday? And just how have you celebrated as a family? Just keep it light, cordial. Obviously, we're going to be getting Dr. Howard on soon because he was hilarious. But, you know, give a shout out to our viewers as well for participating and being with us this time. And we'll be approaching the year in March. So we are very appreciative of you guys. But this will be the next podcast. So if you would like to share anything that you do for the holidays that's unique, Black centric, or just religious, whatever you have going on. Sure, go ahead.
Hey guys, if you would please send us pictures of you and your family for Thanksgiving so that when we get on Sunday, we can load them and we can share them with everybody. And then just tell us a little bit about your tradition and we'll talk about it on the show.
Yes, we can make it flexible too. If you do send pictures, we can have you on the show and share the link. And so you can just give us some type of, you know, just conversation around what your picture was about, how do you guys celebrate, things like that. We want to show, again, this show is about showing Black positivity and Black excellence. And so what great way of doing that by showing great Black family pictures right around holiday season. You don't see that everywhere, right? So, and this was a Candace's idea again. So great job, Candace, with that.
Thank you.
But with that said, we would like to close out. You guys enjoy your week. We love you. See you next time.
Love you guys. See you in 2 weeks.